You just take it off the line and replace it. Peter, in Zeitgeist Addendum, you also dealt with something that very interesting some of our listeners may not be familiar with, but it was the idea of the economic hitmen. Actually, these individuals working for other companies who go down to different countries and represent the interests of banks, their purpose being to indebt that country. Could you speak a little bit about that?
Sure. It's again, it's a mafia scenario. The interest of banks and corporations. Government, banks, and corporations are always in conjunction with each other. And John Perkins is a perfect example of a manifestation of that. And, you know, what it comes down to is quite simplistic. It's no different than the gaming strategies, the corrupt gaming strategies you see with monopolistic collusion between two corporations that want to get one over on a competing corporation, so they join together. These issues are incredible to me. When it comes to Latin America, I think it's the most profound example. In Ecuador, you know, that leader was completely taken out because of his lack of concordance with the interests of the West. And, you know, the patterns are so transparent. They tried to take out Chavez. We all know that, the coup of 2002 or 2003, if I remember correctly. And, of course, you know, no one really talks about that. Chavez certainly does. He knows exactly what happened.
Yeah.
And, you know, of course, what do the states do? They work their propaganda machine to demonize Chavez. So now if you ask most Americans about Chavez, he's just, you know, another corrupt Latin American dictator, they would call him. And that's the power of propaganda in the West.
Well, John Perkins.
And actually, he was one of the ones who stood up to offer aid to New Orleans.
Yes, exactly. Actually, he was shipping in oil to one of the states in America. when oil prices hit their peak in America, he offered this one particular state through a third party, well, a non-major oil pipeline to provide oil at 50% the cost to one of the U.S. states. I wish I had the full information on that. It was a great act of poetry on his part, just to show his kinship with people in America, not necessarily the government. But it's quite amazing. But you know, the economic hitmen concept goes way back, and there's really no mystery to it. The CIA is documented over and over and over again for running little games for Wall Street, from heroin. Afghanistan, obviously, as we all know, at least most of us should know, is basically about drugs. And if you ask most Americans, why are we in Afghanistan? They'll say terrorism. No. It's hilarious. No American would even know why we're in Afghanistan. Ask anybody why we're in Afghanistan. They probably won't even be able to give you an answer. And the answer is drugs, because Wall Street would collapse if it wasn't for drug money laundering. The collusion of drugs and I don't want to go into all of that, but the basic issue is that the monetary system has created such rampant criminality that nothing will surprise me anymore. And back to the original point that we were talking about regarding the transitions, one thing I wanted to throw out there that's important for people to think about is that there's no way the established structure we have today is going to be able to take care of the people that are growing in population. In other words, we have 1 billion people starving on this planet right now. It's going to get worse and worse and worse because we're perpetuating scarcity. So the pressure of that, the horrors that we're going to face in the future because of the growing population in the third world and the lack of production to provide for them is going to be cataclysmically motivational, I think, for a lot of people, because we're going to be seeing more wars, we're going to be seeing more horrors that I think most really don't expect, but it's going to get worse and worse and worse. There's no path for it to get better, unfortunately, because of population growth. There's no way the system will maintain the growing population based on the statistical growth.
And one of the things that John Perkins pointed out in Addendum is so much, not all of it, but so many of the cases he related were related to oil. And so what we've got is a dwindling resource for which people are willing to go to more and more extreme lengths. And I really encourage everyone to go see these movies. I encourage everyone to go to the Venus Project and also sign up for Zeitgeist the Movement. Become an activist for being involved in changing the world. And I think that's what you were referring to earlier, Roxanne. You said if we're going to spend energy in a new direction. It doesn't hurt to spend energy in a direction that's helpful, but really spend that energy where we can make a significant difference and maybe get off that monetary-based economy.
Right. Put the effort in learning more about the Venus Project, the Zeitgeist Movement, watch Peter Joseph's films, look at what our films and what we have on the Venus the Venus Project website. And yes, it takes just as much effort to look into that. And our real safety is how many people know about this direction. We have tours here at the Venus Project where you can come and Jacques will speak for 4 to 6 hours and see the models. We have hundreds of models of what the future could be like. We're trying to get a major motion picture off the ground showing a positive future. There really are no major motion pictures on a positive future. And we look at it almost as social therapy for a transition, so people will understand what they could have, what the future could be, and what they're missing. So we're trying to do that also, and Peter is working on more projects and another film, and he has done more to get this off the ground than anything so far.
Well, let's go ahead. We've got another commercial break to take, and when we come back, perhaps we could hear both from Jacques and Roxanne and Peter on what the future holds and what you're doing and how you would like our listeners and us to be involved and be engaged. This is AM 540 KRXA with Solazar and Kirilani, and we'll be right back with more Good Vibrations.
Welcome back. You're listening to Good Vibrations, Tools for Transformation with Solazar and Kirilani on AM 540 KRXA.
And this is Solazar, and we're talking with Jacques Fresco and Roxanne Meadows from the Venus Project and Peter Joseph, producer of Zeitgeist and Zeitgeist Addendum. And during the break, Patrick from Monterey called in and had a question for Roxanne. Patrick, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Okay, and Roxanne, can you hear Patrick?
Yes, I can.
Okay, good. Patrick, go ahead and ask your question.
Gosh, you know, I wasn't even expecting. I'm driving home from, you know, the grocery store here, but I'm a big fan of both Zeitgeist and the Addendum, but, you know, as we know, there's been some criticisms. Where do I start? How the hell do we get to where you guys are? I mean, how do we get to, aside from my sharing, you know, the DVD with people,
In other words,
I've shown people the Addendum, and I say, oh, my God, isn't this amazing? Like, wouldn't that be nice if we were, like, what about, you know, first of all, we're, like, a planet of 6.8 to 6.9 billion people, and when they showed the diagrams, you know, the artist renderings of, hey, we could have it all. I mean, how do we compensate for the third world? And also, you know, Tom Hartman has mentioned on several times on his show that if we were to have the third world. If we were to have the third world living at the standards of the first world, we would need four planet Earths worth of natural resources. But we just don't have the natural resources to have everyone on the planet live, you know, like they do in Europe and America and the West.
Okay, Jacques or Roxanne or Peter, would you like to respond to that?
Sure.
Go ahead, Roxanne.
That comment about... we don't have the resources. It's not really true. We do have the resources, but we don't have the resources to fulfill the needs of the third world the way we're doing it today. This system is extremely wasteful, and there would be nothing like the waste of resources within a resource-based economy that we have today. And you can see this in all aspects by the way the cities are designed, the way we do new types of transportation, the way we use and the way we generate energy. We go into all that with the Zeitgeist films and in on our website. So it's a very different way of thinking and a different way of organizing society. in terms of how we get from here to there, you know, like